First man he faces is Michael Conforto. Bobby Valentine is with us. Bobby, you had a close personal friend who perished in the Twin Towers on 9/11.
Yeah, there are a couple, but I guess you're referring to Chris Quackenbush.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was an amazing thing. He came to one of my charity auctions and bid on that boy for a day at the All-Star Game out in Seattle. He brought his kids out there. We sat on the field. We watched Home Run Derby, and that was the last game that the family saw together. They were season box holders. He was the founder of Sandler O'Neill, and he went to work that day. Yes.
Slow bouncer over the mound, and LeMay, who couldn't handle it as he charged. So Conforto reaches on what will likely be ruled an infield hit, and it is.
Yeah, and he was a great guy, and actually I sprinkled some of his ashes over in the old Shea Stadium left field, close to where their seats were, and as things come around, you can imagine that last year during COVID, when they had all the cutouts being made, I had a friend, Brian Baliff, get a couple of cutouts of me in the nose and glasses and then buy them for seats here at City Field. The person that he was in contact with, who was handling the sales, was C.J. Quackenbush, the young man that I was, the young boy that I was with on the field, the All-Star game, 20 years ago, now working for the Mets.
So many interconnections.
Right. How crazy.
So many lives entwined.